career, accelerometer, acoustic, eavesdropping, with unconstrained vocabulary. Nowadays, voice-based applications on smartphones are part of our daily lives, such as voice navigation, audio message, audio call, voice assistant, and music. Since the audio from such applications reveals sensitive information about the user, mobile operating systems grant access to the microphone only with explicit user permission. Therefore, the attacker can't access the microphone to obtain the private audio information. To bypass this restriction, security researchers have proposed alternative methods to access the audio by proposing several eavesdropping techniques based on side channels. In particular, they found that the motion sensors, such as gyroscope and accelerometer, can be affected by the sound played by a speaker. Moreover, attacker can access such motion sensors without user permission. So we can leverage the unrestricted motion sensors as a side channel to carry out acoustic eavesdropping attacks. Among the work in the literature, Michael Levsky et al. Recognized the user's identity and retrieved some words from the data of smartphones built-in gyroscope by placing the smartphone and active loudspeaker on the same solid surface. Zhang et al. Extract the unique signatures of the hot words from accelerometer data by holding the smartphone in their hand or placing it on the desk and speak to the phone. Ananda et al. Argued that both human and machine-rendered speech is not powerful enough to affect smartphone motion sensors through the air. Fa et al. Found that vibration produced by the speaker can propagate through the motherboard and induce strong response on the accelerometer, so they utilized the accelerometer measurements to recognize and reconstruct digits, characters, and some hot words. All these works share the same disadvantage since they can only recognize hot words from the pre-established vocabulary. However, in a real-world scenario, audio emitted by the speaker contains much more information. Therefore, only focusing on a limited set of hot words would drastically reduce the eavesdropping capabilities of the proposed attacks. To solve this problem, we propose Acquia, an acoustic eavesdropping system that uses accelerometer data to accurately reconstruct the user speech played by the smartphone speaker. Acquia is the first method that actually recovers the speech content with an unconstrained vocabulary rather than cognizing individual hot words. As a goal feature of our proposed method, we can convert low-frequency accelerometer data into a high-frequency comprehensible audio signal via a conditional GAN. Hence, we can substantially enhance our eavesdropping capabilities even when the available data has limited resolution due to hardware or software restrictions. To better understand our method, we need to take a step back and give some preliminary information. An accelerometer is a three-axis sensor that sends and measures acceleration. It's one of the primary sensors embedded into smartphones and has been widely used for gaming, health tracking, and activity recognition. Android operating systems, apps to access accelerometer data at various sampling rates. However, due to the limitations posed by different smartphone manufacturers, the maximum sampling rate of accelerometer for this mode can vary between 416 to 500 Hz on modern smartphones. According to Nyquist sampling theorem, this means that we can only capture the information below 250 Hz when the sampling rate of the accelerometer is 500 Hz. To construct audio information, we consider the phonemes as a fundamental building block of human speech. Phonemes are the smallest phonological units divided according to natural properties of speech. We take English language as an example. The phonemes in English are classified into categories, vowel words and consonants. The number of vowel words is 20 and their energy mainly distributes below 2000 Hz, while the number of consonants is 28 and their energy mainly distributes below 8000 Hz. However, the accelerometer can only capture limited speech information due to the low sampling rate. These figures show the spectrogram of the accelerometer data and the corresponding spectrogram of audio for vowel words and consonants. We can observe unique patterns for each phoneme on the spectrograms of both accelerometer and audio. Based on this observation, we can devise an approach which learns the mappings between the accelerometer data and the audio. Besides, it should have the capability to automatically generate the missing high-frequency components with the low-frequency accelerometer data based on the previously learned mappings. To achieve this goal, we leverage conditional generative adversarial networks to learn the mappings between the accelerometer data and the audio. The generator G of conditional GAN aims to generate data from a noise vector Z under the input condition Y. Besides, the discriminator D aims to distinguish the generated data from the ground truth X. In our work, the condition Y denotes the accelerometer data and the ground truth X denotes the original audio. So the conditional GAN can generate audio from accelerometer data, which is similar to original audio. In our threat model, we assume a spyware has been installed on the victim's smartphone that collects the accelerometer data in the background. When the built-in speaker of the victim's phone plays the sound, spyware records accelerometer data on all three edges at the maximum sampling rate. Hence, the attacker can only access the raw accelerometer data to carry out the eavesdropping attack. The architecture of ACK-EAR had two major components: feature extraction and speech reconstruction. In the feature extraction component, we mainly transform the raw accelerometer data to a spectrogram. First, we apply a zero mean normalization on the raw accelerometer data. Since the time interval between samples is not constant, we interpolate the accelerometer data to obtain a fixed time interval between samples. After interpolation, we apply a high-pass filter to remove the part of the signal due to the human activities, for example, hand movements and walking. Finally, we transform the processed accelerometer data into a spectrogram. In the speech reconstruction component, we use a conditional GAN to enhance the obtained accelerometer spectrogram via the generation of the high-frequency features, which are absent from the original accelerometer data. The conditional GAN consists of a generator and a discriminator. In the training process, the given accelerometer data spectrogram is input as a condition, and the corresponding original audio spectrum is ground truth. The generator aims to produce a spectrum as similar as possible to ground truth according to the input accelerometer data spectrum. The discriminator tries to distinguish the generated audio from ground truth. The game between generator and discriminator will go on until the generated audio and ground truth cannot be distinguished anymore. Therefore, from an accelerometer spectrum as input, the final model can produce the corresponding audio. In our experimental evaluation, we collected the audio samples from 8 English-speaking and 8 Chinese-speaking public personalities whose utterances are available on the internet. We report the detailed information in the table below. We evaluate our attack performance via mild capture distortion MCD, mean opening score MOS, and word error rate WER respectively. For MCD and WER, a lower value indicates a better reconstruction performance, while for MOS, a higher value indicates a better reconstruction performance. Note that an audio is still considered intelligible as long as MCD is lower than 8. For each user, we train a separate model. The following three figures show the MCD, MOS, WER values for each user model. The average values of MCD are lower than 8, and the average values of MOS are higher than 3. In addition, the average values of WER are lower than 20%. To demonstrate the transferability of the model, we collect the test data under different settings, such as different audio output volume, placement, scenarios, and sampling rate. We can see the average MCD values are still lower than 8. Then we perform the experiments on different models of smartphones and tablets. We can see that in most cases, our model can transfer well across different devices, as the MCD values are under 6.5. We train to general model for English and Chinese respectively. It should be noted that users in testing data do not appear in the training data. Nonetheless, we can obtain an intelligible reconstructed audio since the average MCD values are also lower than 8. We also perform a cross-user training. The x-axis denotes the training data and the y-axis denotes the testing data. We can see the audio reconstruction performance of model to cross-user is still good in most cases. As MCD is the most widely used metric to measure the audio reconstruction performance, we explore corresponding relationship between the MCD and reconstruct results. In the table, we can see that with MCD in the range of 2 to 6, the reconstruct results are ideal. And when the MCD between 6 and 8, the reconstruct performance is decreasing. However, we think that it would still be possible to infer the unrecognized words through the context or via NLP. In conclusion, we propose IKEA, an eavesdropping system that reconstructs the audio played by built-in speaker from accelerometer data. We show that we can leverage conditional gain to convert low-frequency accelerometer data into a comprehensible audio signal. Finally, we extensively evaluate IKEA on different smartphones and users, achieving high accuracy under various settings and scenarios. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you for your listening. I would be happy to answer to your questions.
Please go ahead. Questions?
Hi, thanks for the talk. Chen Wang from ISU, the one of the authors of a spear phone paper you cite in your paper. So actually, it's very impressive to see you are able to isolate the phonemes, because in our work, we find even it's hard, it's very challenging to isolate words. So can you explain more about how you isolate or separate the phonemes and recognize each phoneme?
In the training process, we don't isolate the phonemes. We train a long sentence directly, but to demonstrate the phonemic patterns are unique, we search the unique pronunciation from the internet and collect their accelerometer data to perform the experiments and plot the spectrums.
Okay, yeah, thanks.
Lea Schoenherr from CISPA. Have you tried to use the accelerometer data to train a speech recognition directly instead of transferring the features?
No, we didn't train a speech recognition model directly. We train the speech reconstruction model to directly reconstruct the video.
Okay, any other questions? Okay, then let's thank the speaker again and for showing up to answer questions remotely. It's wonderful. And thanks to all the speakers as well for the session.